This is a MiniDV camcorder that records on a MiniDV cassette. Consumer-grade MiniDV camcorders can have up to 4 types of inputs and outputs: composite, S-video, FireWire, and USB. The best and the standard way to transfer video off a DV camcorder is to use IEEE 1394 Digital Link, also known as FireWire, iLink or MIL1394, or simply as DV connector. Almost all DV camcorders have a FireWire port. Smaller consumer camcorders have a 4-pin port. Some larger camcorders have a 6-pin port. You can connect 4-pin FireWire to 6-pin with a cable. Originally, FireWire has been designed for transfer speeds up to 400 Mbps per second, but unless labeled, digital camcorders and videotape recorders use the slower 100 Mbps per second protocol. In 2003, FireWire 800 introduced higher transfer speed and support for longer cables. The connector has 9 pins, and you can convert between the first generation and the second generation with a simple cable. Apple was the original developer of FireWire and included it in all of its products during late 1990s and 2000s.
Today, we are officially rolling out FireWire as part of our product line on the motherboard of every new PowerMac G3. You can connect FireWire to a zillion things. First of all, there's the digital camcorders, of which there are now 4 million of in the world. All those digital camcorders have FireWire jacks on them. You can take that FireWire jack and plug it right into the back of your G3 and bring in digital video with pristine digital quality with no add-in boards, no extra expense. We think this is going to be a really big deal.
In 2012, Apple introduced Lightning connector and removed FireWire port from its mobile devices. In the same year, FireWire was removed from the third generation MacBook, replaced with Thunderbolt. It is possible to convert FireWire to Thunderbolt with an adapter. These adapters are out of production and their price on used market has skyrocketed. There is no generic FireWire to USB adapter. Do not believe scammers on eBay or Amazon.
I'm not going to risk any of my legacy technology by plugging these things in blindly. So let's cut them open and see what's inside.
There are devices like Pinnacle 500 USB and 700 USB that convert analog composite, analog as video, as well as DV into digital video over USB. But you cannot convert FireWire to USB with a simple cable. The second digital interface option is USB. Basically, there are three cases for using USB port on a MiniDV camcorder. First is the USB port is used to transfer files from a memory card, which is used in many MiniDV camcorders for still images as well as for short, low-resolution videos. This is the memory card that came with this camcorder, 16 megabytes. It is good for 21 megapixel photos or for a 50-second video, having a resolution of 320 by 240. In this case, USB is used for file-based transfer, so it's nothing special. The second option is using the camcorder as a webcam. The resolution and the frame rate are low, and if some frames are dropped or the video freezes, it's no big deal, so many camcorders have this mode. Finally, the functionality that we're looking for is transferring video of tape in full resolution in real time. This one is hard to ascertain. You need to thoroughly study the user manual, and even then, you might still remain in the woods. A user manual simply mentioning USB is not good enough, but USB 2 high speed is a good sign. It is nice to have a clear indication of what the camcorder can do. Like here, the camcorder can only transfer files over USB when used with a Mac. This was okay when all Macs had FireWire ports for transferring videos. When connected to a Windows machine, the same camcorder can use USB for transferring videos as well, but only on Windows XP. Windows ME and 2000 are too old. Sadly, I don't have a Windows XP machine. What about Windows 7 32-bit starter edition on my netbook? Installing drivers was a pain, and I want to thank Brad, who helped me find the drivers and other software for this camcorder. In the end, this didn't work. I managed to start the image mixer, but when I clicked on the import video button, it crashed. But wait! I was able to transfer DV video over USB to Windows 7 and Windows 10 machines truly in a plug-and-play fashion using this Panasonic camcorder, the GS500. I have a separate video where I demonstrate how to transfer full resolution video from MiniDV camcorder to a Windows computer over USB. You may want to check it out. See the link in the description. What can you do if your computer does not have a FireWire port and your camcorder cannot send video over USB? In this case, analog connection is your last resort. Composite video is the lowest common denominator. Usually composite video connector has this barrel shape, known as RCA type connector. Often it's accompanied with one or two connectors that transmit single or dual channel audio. A smaller camcorder may use a 4-pole tip ring ring sleeve connector that combines composite video and 2-channel audio. If you are going to use a connector like this, make sure the cable pinout matches your camcorder, as there are several variations. S-video is a better quality analog connection type. It allows to achieve slightly higher detail and better color separation. Do not forget that S-video transfers video only. You need to transfer audio via a separate cable. Because composite and S-video are analog technologies, you should use the same approach you would use to capture VHS or 8mm video. That is, you need to employ an analog-to-digital converter and an appropriate software. I have a separate video dedicated to capturing of analog video on Windows. I also produced several reviews of different brands of analog converters. I will put all these links in the description. Thank you, goodbye. Please like and subscribe.